Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to Delta Force 2. We are continuing with the quick mission independent scenarios. The next mission at hand is mission stolen goods. Recently, an NBC briefcase was stolen from a courier. I don't know whether I should call it Anne or O, because while speaking, I mean, it starts with a vowel, right? So maybe Anne? But then again, when you write it, recently, NBC briefcase was stolen from a courier. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Infiltrate the enemy campers is being held and retrieve it, and that is as simple as it gets. It seems to be a night mission. Yes, it is. $2,200. Clear skies in the Middle East. I guess we check out the briefing then. Doesn't really give you a lot more information apart from that.
2 weeks ago, an NBC case was stolen from a military courier, and Intel believes it is to be sold on the black market. A tracking device inside the case shows its location at a fortified paramilitary camp. Your mission is to infiltrate the enemy camp and retrieve the case. Bravo will insert west of the objective and locate the case. Once the package is secure, rendezvous with Black Widow south of the target for extraction. Armed guards patrol the camp, but we do not expect heavy weapons or air support.
Expect the unexpected. That is what is important. Anyhow, for starters, I don't really know what an NBC briefcase is. News and Broadcasting Corporation. News Broadcasting Corporation, I don't really know. But I'll put it right here once I figure out whatever it is. And yeah, it seems to be a night mission, but I will not be taking the SMG because, well, the range is... I think I'll need a better range. Yeah, as much as I thought, I would rather stick to the M4 carbine with the grenade launcher. Kevlar vest is completely useless, so instead of the Kevlar vest, we might as well take... Well, video camera won't really help, to be honest. We can take the ghillie suit, it will help us maintain stealth. And I don't think there are as many enemies that we require two boxes of extra ammunition, so let's start. Let's start this mission.
All King elements, the package contains level 4 contaminant. Proceed with extreme caution.
Roger,
Alpha Team, provide overwatch.
Alpha Team, in position.
So the enemies in this level are a little too accurate.
Bravo, this is King 6. Recon the target. No!
And when I say a little too accurate, I mean way too accurate. Now, I don't need to destroy this tent here, but the only reason that I'm doing it is to deal with some enemies that will show up later. But as for the enemies that are showing up right now, they are pretty difficult as well. Primarily because they are, one, difficult to spot, and two, way too accurate. This guy has another buddy. I'm just wondering where this guy's buddy
Bravo,
is.
Bravo, this is Alpha One. You got bad guys coming over the hill.
That was a swift response this time around. Thought it would take more time. I'm just going prone here so that it takes them a bit of time to actually see me. Hopefully, I mean, if done correctly, they won't be able to spot me at all. So that is what I'm wishing for. But yeah, sometimes it's visual thinking. Sometimes it's harsh reality.
Bravo, you're approaching the main camp. Proceed with caution.
Now, the enemies that come over the hill, those guys are way too accurate, in my opinion. I mean, their first shot will hit you. And just to keep you guys up to date, we can't exactly go around blowing these tents up like this. We need to be extra cautious with how we play this level. And there he is, the guy that I'm missing all over the place. So yeah, there'll be like a few squads that come up to just to shoot you. Excuse me? Can you die, please? Thank you. It took you long enough. Wow. Is anybody there? Huh. I thought there was somebody there. So yeah, might as well wait it out until these guys arrive, because if you try to rush things, those guys will get you. The guys on top of the ridge, I mean. My aim sucks today, so yeah. I'm also playing it a little cautiously. Now, there are some bad guys that are going to be coming over the hill. And you want to be cautious of those guys, because those guys can essentially fuck you up in a matter of seconds. I think the coast is clear for now. We can proceed ahead without too many interruptions, I do believe. There should be a guy right ahead of us, like right in front of us. We will be able to see him momentarily, but until then, better to remain cautious. Yeah, there he is. I'm just trying to see if there are any enemies here. There is one. There's one enemy. And then there are like a bootload of others over the hill. But the only reason that I'm coming here is to get a better vantage point on this side of the camp. If there are any enemies inside this tent, they will not be an issue because, well, I think that's where the container is, and how I know that is because, well, I sort of blew up that tent on my first playthrough.
King 6, Alpha 1, no sign of the case yet.
Roger, Alpha, keep looking.
And, yeah, the case sort of blew up. And we were more or less left. Should be enough of an elevation, I guess. I think that kills the one guy that was in there. I'm gonna be extra cautious with my approach here because, you know what, might as well just take the time to take out an enemy's. Over on that side, because that is where they tend to show up from. Can you like shoot again? Yeah, sorry. Like if it wasn't for the tracers in this game, it would be so difficult just to spot the enemies. And I'm thankful that they actually use tracer rounds. Now the reason I'm coming here is so that I can spot the enemies that are supposed to be here. I hope I do not get shot while retreating. That would suck. Primarily because I'm lagging so hard. Pretty sure there are a few more over there. Oh, I saw a glimpse of Alpha 1 for a second there. Excuse me. Don't see any more of these guys, so I think we're clear for now. Might as well head down and don't know if that did anything, but yeah. Where I think the briefcase is in that tent. How I know is, well, I blew it up on my first run through, and that's when the contamination started spreading, and that's when my character died as well. Even though the sounds were coming from somewhere down there in the valley. But I'm quite certain that the briefcase is in there. Excuse me. Well, thank you for not killing me outright. I sort of dislike the way that the game handled it. The reload there. Just two enemies in there. Shot somewhere in the leg region. I think I see something there. I just wish that it was easier to, you know. You know what, this is a bad angle of approach. Let's go around the back. This guy's dead, that much I know. Yeah, Yeah, so this is the briefcase that we need to collect.
This is King 6. Bravo has the package. All units move to the primary LZ. Black Widow, this is King 6. All units moving to extraction point.
Roger, King 6. On station and standing by.
Alright, let's move to the primary LZ, wherever that is. And hopefully nobody shoots us dead while we're doing it. Because there were supposed to be enemies right here. Is that the Black Widow? I sure hope it is. Because otherwise, well, we're sort of fucked if it isn't. For a night mission, the enemies are, surprisingly aware and accurate of you in this level, specifically. I think that is an enemy. Yes, it is. Hit him with two bullets, one shot, went straight. Hopefully it does not fuck up somebody's day. Those are Alphas 1 and 2. And somebody else is shooting at us. I don't know who it is, but somebody else is shooting at us. Probably that guy's buddy somewhere over there. I mean, that's the red guy that I shot. I would not like to stick around here, to be honest. Wait, no, that's just a tree. Keep presenting myself as a target, I mean. That would be a foolish course of action. So, well, I mean, I guess it is a pretty well moonlit night, being the reason why no enemies there. The enemies can see us so easily, but still, I mean, they're way too accurate for, especially for a night mission in this level. Well, not everything is perfect. You know how it is. But do I need to get there or something? Yeah. The way this game is programmed is sometimes a little strange. Anyhow. King 6, this is Bravo 1. Alpha team alongside Bravo 1 is RTP, over and out. I don't know how to say that properly in military speech. Anyhow, that was Mission Stolen Goods, a short mission, but a little odd though. I mean, you have to literally wait around and take care of the enemies that literally rush towards you. It reminds me of Delta Force 1, where the enemies used to do that a lot. They don't do that anymore in this game. And this is honestly the first time that I've seen enemies doing that. There have been times during the campaign when I've seen them doing that, but not typically. I mean, I think it's the only mission where I actually saw them doing that was Mission Knockout. But not apart from that, I mean, enemies snaking in the grass and running towards you, trying to flank you and everything. So, yeah. I mean, even though the enemy AI is set to advanced for me, it's just not taking effect in most cases. So, well, that's what this mission is about. Anyhow, with the enemy AI set to advance, it becomes more of a passive game. Delta Force, with it turned off, it just becomes more of a, point and shoot kind of simulator. Anyhow, that was enough for Mission Stolen Goods. Thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around until the end. When we come back, we will be covering Mission Frontrunner, which takes place in East Africa, and it takes place early in the morning. So, it seems to be a convoy ambush mission. So, I'll see you then. Take care. Farewell, fellow things.